Good morning, dear friends. Today we just continue the discussion of capital gain. In our last discussion, we learned that the charging section for taxing the income under the capital gain is section 45. We also learned that any capital gain or profit which arises from the transfer of capital asset and such transfer has been effected in the previous year is chargeable under the head the income from house property unless there is exemption under various sections, section 54, section 54B, G, like that on. We also learned that what is included in the capital asset means we just elaborately understood the definition of capital asset. What is specifically excluded from the definition of capital asset? We also learned the difference between the short term capital gain and the long term capital gain. We also learned the short term capital asset, the meaning of long term capital asset, because the incidence of tax depends upon the type of capital gain. I also told you that the taxation rate, the rate of tax is different in the case of short term capital gain, because it is more in the case of short term capital gain, and it is slightly less in the long term capital gain, or it may be exempted also, that we will just try to learn in the subsequent discussions. So we will just continue with this topic. I just told you that the capital gain arises only when there is a transfer of capital asset. If there is no transfer of capital asset, then there shall not arise any capital gain. So, first of all, there should be transfer, then there should be capital asset, and such transfer of the capital asset should have resulted in the capital gain. Only then the gain or profit shall be subject to tax under this head. Now the question arises, what exactly is the transfer? What is the transfer of capital assets? Because this is a very, very core area. If there is no transfer, it means there shall not arise any capital gain to be taxed under this head. So, what exactly is the transfer? Transfer in the context of capital asset includes, what is included in that? The sale of property. Because I just want to tell you, in nowhere in the act the word sale has been written as a definition, because if you just recapitulate the section 45, the provision of section 45, which clearly says that any capital gain or profit which arises from the transfer of capital asset, it does not say the sale of capital asset. It means we are more concerned with the word transfer. Now, what exactly is a transfer? What is included in the transfer? That we'll just try to learn. So, the transfer in the context of capital asset includes the sale of property, exchange. Exchange may be mutual transfer of ownership of property, relinquishment of any asset. It may be voluntary giving up of any right in the property in favor of another person against some consideration, extinguishment of rights therein, compulsory acquisition there under any law. If compulsory acquisition has been of the property has been made or has been effected by the government, then it would also be coming within the purview of the word transfer. Or the conversion of individual assets into the stock and trade of his business or profession. If, for example, if a person is having some assets and he is just transferring these assets into his business as a stock and transfer, and if any profit arises out of it, and not profit, that conversion shall be deemed to be the transfer. The maturity or redemption of zero coupon bonds, or any transfer which involves the allowing of the position of any movable property to be taken or retained in part performance of the contract. So these are some of the transactions which are deemed to be included under the word transfer. So if these transactions happen, then they will just cater to the meaning of the word transfer. If any capital gain or profit arises out of such transactions, then it will be chargeable under the head capital gain, because this is one of the very, very important ingredients for the purpose of computing the capital gain. I just told you earlier also, there should be a capital asset, number one, and profit or loss, profit or gain should have arisen out of the transfer. It means the transfer is a very, very important concept in determining the capital gain. If there is no transfer, then there shall not arise any capital gain or profit. So it's a very, very important ingredients in capital gain. Now we have learned what is included in the transfer. Now we just try to understand what is not included in the transfer, means what is not regarded as transfer for the purpose of charging section 45. So what is not included in the transfer is a first is the distribution of capital asset on the partition of actuaries. If there is any distribution of capital assets and this distribution of assets is being made at the time of partition of actuaries, then it shall not be deemed to be the transfer for the purpose of section 45. Number two is a transfer under gift, will or inheritance. It will not be regarded as a transfer. Number three is a transfer of capital assets under amalgamation if the amalgamated company is an Indian company, or the transfer of capital assets by certain holding companies or subsidiary companies, or any transfer of by way of the merger company. So these are some of the specified cases under which the transaction shall not be deemed to be the transfer. So as such, if this is not deemed to be transfer, it is not regarded as transfer. If any capital gain or profit arises out of such transaction, out of such transfer, shall not be deemed to be the capital gain under section 45. So we know what is included in the transfer and what is excluded in the transfer. So what is included in the transfer, if a particular transaction comes within the definition of that including, then the profit shall be subject to tax. If any profit or gain which arises from a transaction which is outside the purview of the world transfer, then it shall not be liable to be taxed under this tariff. Now we just try to learn the method of computing the capital gain, means how to compute the capital gain. We know that there are two types of capital gain. One is a short term capital gain and another is a long term capital gain. So these two types of capital gains are there. Short term capital gain is a gain which just accrues to a person who is just holding the asset for less than 3 years or less than that, and he is just transferring this capital asset. And if any profit is there, then it will be construed as a short term capital gain. If a person transfers, effects the transfer in respect of the long term capital asset, and if any profit or gain arises out of that, then it will be deemed to be the long term capital gain. So the treatment, the tax rate is different, the computation is also different. So we just try to learn the method of computing the capital gain under these two categories. First of all, we just see the short term capital gain. When a person is holding the asset for less than 36 months or less than that, then it will be the short term capital gain. How do we do it? First of all, we just see the sale consideration. What is the sale consideration? Then from the sale consideration, the expenses on account of transfer of asset, if any, they would be deducted. Because if a person is just selling the gold and he is just paying some brokerage or something like that, some commission, then you can say these are the expenses which have been incurred by the SSC in respect of the transfer of this particular capital asset, that could be subject to the deduction from the sale consideration. So the resultant figure could be the net consideration. And from the net consideration, we just make deduction on account of the cost of acquisition of assets or the cost of improvement of the assets, and then we can get the gross capital gain. And if an exemption is there under section 54BD or section 54G, if any, then it will be reduced or it will be deducted from the gross capital gain, and on the net short term capital gain we'll have to pay the tax. So the process is very, very simple. We can just try to learn it with an example. I think the things would be more clear in that. So Mr. S, he purchased gold on 1st March 2007 for rupees 10 lakhs and sells the same on 1st January 2008. It means he is just selling the gold on 1st January 2008 for 12 lakh rupees. Mind it, because he is just selling the gold on 1st of January and he just purchased this gold on 1st of March 2007. It means this is sale date and the purchase date is your 1st March 2007. It means he was just holding the set for less than 3 years, for less than 36 months. So that would be deemed to be the short term capital asset. So accordingly, we'll calculate the short term capital gain also. So this is just for your understanding. So he sold the asset on 1st January 2008 for 12 lakhs. From this 12 lakhs, he incurred the selling expenses, which were to be 2.5% of the sale price. So we can say less selling expenses at the rate of 1% would be 12,000 rupees. The resultant figure would be 11,88,000. From this figure, we just reduce the cost of acquisition. Then less the cost of acquisition has been here 10 lakhs. You bought it for 10 lakhs. Less the cost of improvement, if any. Cost of improvement, if any, because in this case there is no improvement in this case, so that would be nil. So this is my resultant figure, which is coming as 1,88,000. This is the short term capital gain, which shall be subject to tax under section 45. So this is the way we can calculate the short term capital gain. This is the method. It means what you will do? First of all, we will just write the sale consideration. From the sale consideration, you will be deduct the expenses on account of the transfer of assets in this particular case. The selling expenses were there. So the resultant figure is 11,88,000. You can say this is the net consideration which the SSE has got. And from the net consideration, we'll just deduct the cost of acquisition and the cost of improvement. And the cost of acquisition in the proposed case is 10 lakhs. The resulting figure would be the short term capital gain, which is to the tune of 1,88,000. So this is the way we can calculate the short term capital gain. Now we'll just understand how to compute or how to determine the long term capital gain. Now, computation of long term capital gain. Here the procedure is different. First of all, we just record the sale consideration, what is the amount of consideration of sale. From the sale consideration, we'll deduct the expenses on transfer of asset. The resultant would be net consideration, as we just saw in the earlier example. But here, we'll be just reducing the index cost of acquisition. In computing the short-term capital gain, we reduced the cost of acquisition. Here, the index cost of acquisition will be just reducing the index cost of acquisition or the index cost of improvement, and the resulting figure would be the gross capital gain. Now, what is the index cost of acquisition? Because this is the only difference between the computation of short term capital gain and the long term capital gain. In short term capital gain, we just reduce the cost of acquisition.